You're listening to Gigi Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph. Hi, girls. Happy Friday.
Hi, girls. Steph here. Yes, it is finally Friday.
Which means it's the weekend and we can have a few days of rest.
Yes, a break. I mean, you might have assignments and that, but it's a bit more calmer, not so much of a rush.
Yeah, especially in the mornings and getting up way too early.
Yeah.
We get up really early, don't we, in the week?
Oh, yes. I am not a morning person. I can do it, but I'm not happy about it.
I'm a morning person, but even then, I mean, we wake up at 4 in the morning, so it's a stretch.
Yeah.
It does get tiring. All right. So today we have brand new content for you.
Yes, something new that we haven't featured yet. And it is our chapter review, which is a chapter of the Bible that we're going to review and encourage you to read. Over the weekend, this is your homework, I suppose you can call it. Something that's going to really help.
Yes. So as you know, you've been studying and learning verse 2 of Psalms 91. So today the chapter review is on
Psalms 91.
Yes. So just a little bit about the psalm. Steph, what do you have?
Well, actually, something interesting that I didn't know was that these psalms are called poems or songs. And they're actually not written by David. Like, in my mind, they were all just, I assume they're written by King David.
All of them.
All of them, yeah. But they weren't. Like searching through it said some of them were written by Solomon, his son, Moses. Something like, for me, it was a big jump from Genesis to what?
For David as well.
Yeah, David wrote some as well.
There's another man in there who was a musician. I can't remember his name, but I'll have to look it up.
Yeah, and then there's Ezra that was saying, there's other men there. Like, they have usually the names of who wrote it under the titles most of the time, and some are unknown. But this Psalms 91 is actually an unknown. So we're not sure. People say Moses, some people say David. So we actually don't know. It's really interesting.
It is interesting. So girls, if you have a pastor at your church, double check with them and ask them who wrote Psalms 91 and see what they say.
Yeah.
Be good to know. So now going to the verse 2 that you were learning. Did you learn it? Steph, did you learn yours?
I actually did. Yes. So what I did is I wrote it out and then I would say it by memory, then look at what I've missed and just did that for the week. So yes. Actually, I did. I'm quite proud of myself.
And I said I was going to learn it because I know it in Spanish.
And did you learn it in English?
Yes, it's getting there. I have to say, girls, it's getting there. So the verse was, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Now, I want to explain that just a little bit. So just a quick explanation from the Bible commentary. Or commentary of what this verse says. And I just want you to look at one section. It says, He is my refuge and my fortress. So in the Bible commentary, it's saying that when you say, He is my, you're taking kind of like ownership.
You know,
He is my refuge. You're not saying God is a refuge. He is my refuge.
I hadn't actually picked that up, but no, now that I can hear you saying it, like, oh yeah, you're it is my, not our.
Yes.
Okay, yep.
And so that kind of, you know, gives it a little bit, for me personally, gives it a little bit more, makes it more personal and makes it that God is mine and He is going to look after me.
And I think that is the point of the Bible. Like, God wanted to leave it to make it personal for us, to show us that, you know, He is there for us as He was for them.
That's right. So girls, we just want to encourage you to go and find the verse. If you haven't learned it, that's fine. You can learn it throughout the next few months. Like, it's good. And if you find a place, put it up on your wall or your mirror and just revise over it and claim it as, you know, God is my refuge and my strength and He will, you know, look after me.
Yeah.
So today's devotional is called Spread Your Wings, author unknown. One day a man was walking through the woods and found an eagle chick. When he saw him unprotected, he decided to take him home and put him in a chicken coop. While there, the chick learned to eat the same food as the chickens and to behave like them. One day, a man expert in zoology passed by and asked the owner of the chicken coop why he had an eagle locked up in the pen. Well, the owner replied, I don't know. I guess it's because I have given him the same food and he has always been amongst the chickens, and so he has never learned to fly. It behaves like them, so it's no longer an eagle, but another chicken. However, the zoologist insisted, it is an eagle and has instincts to fly, and it can certainly be taught to do so. The zoologist gently took the eagle in his arms and said, you belong to heaven, not to earth. You are not a chicken. Open your wings and fly. The eagle, however, was confused, and seeing that the chickens were eating, he jumped up and met them again. The next day, the zoologist took the eagle to the roof of the house and encouraged it, saying again, you are an eagle. Spread your wings and fly. But the eagle jumped once more in the search of the chicken's food. The zoologist got up early on the third day and took the eagle out of the pen and onto a mountain. He raised her directly into the sun. The eagle began to tremble, slowly spread its wings, and finally, with a triumphant screech, it flew off into the sky.
I really love that story, and especially because eagles are such an amazing and majestic animal. They're very awe-inspiring and just...
loyal.
Yes, stunning.
Yes. Do you know that eagles actually stay with their mate for life?
I had heard that somewhere. Ooh. And I know you've got more facts on eagles, which are your favorite animal.
Yes.
But we'll come back after this song.
Me that you'd hold me in your loving.
That was Only You by Charmaine. So Esther, what are the eagle facts you have?
Okay, so the eagle has been considered the king of birds.
Oh, really?
And there are over 60 different species of eagles in the world.
Wow, I actually did not know that.
No, me neither. It is recorded that eagles can carry more than 6 kilos. As in a load, carry something.
Okay, so if they catch something.
It can weigh up to 6 kilos. 6 kilos is quite heavy.
Interesting, but a bag of rice is like a kilo, and then six of those.
Yes.
That's quite heavy.
That's right. Also, they have brilliant eyesight, and that's because of its sizable eyes, which can take up to 50% of the head. And yes, and like I said before, they're extremely loyal. They stay with their partner, their mate, for the rest of their lives.
Oh, that's nice.
It is. They're sweet. Okay, girls, so what can we learn from that story that we just read about the eagle? Steph, what do you think you can learn from it?
Well, my initial perspective was that, you know, maybe the company you keep is dragging you down or not letting you look up.
Yes.
That's what I got from it. But I don't know if that's what it actually is.
Yeah, but it's also, you know, God wants us to or expects us to succeed in every area of our lives. So you know how chickens always look down and they're always pecking the ground?
They barely ever
look up.
That's true.
So God doesn't want us to live with a downcast gaze, looking down, seeing the bad circumstances in life all the time, like all the negative. We're in the world. Everything is pretty nasty at times. But God wants us to look up. Think about reaching far beyond what others have reached.
So not getting bogged down by your circumstances.
Yes.
So even though things are hard, you still keep moving forward, looking up and trusting God.
Trusting God. Be the eagle, girls. Fly high. Dream big. And with God's help, you can do it.
So what's happening in Charlotte Bay? Inside scoop on Giselle.
Okay, so Giselle is the protagonist of our story. She's 16 years old. Now, her dream is to travel around Europe, but she needs the money for that. So she needs the money to buy, you know, get the ticket, get a passport. Giselle is in year 12, last year of schooling, and is getting ready or is in the mindset to travel. But her mom is against her finding a job. She wants her to concentrate in school and do her best. But Giselle doesn't want to listen to her. So she gets a job at Kim's Deli Cafe.
But she gets that job behind her mother's back. And she also lies to Kim, which is the lady in charge of the cafe, saying that her mom was completely cool with her going for the job.
She's also been asked to get a reference because, you know, when you go for a job, you get a resume and you have reference. So the pastor's wife is her referee. But when the pastor's wife asks Giselle if her mom is okay with it, Giselle lies, saying, yes, she is okay with
Giselle.
It. So in honor of Giselle starting a new job at the Deli Cafe, we are going to be sharing our Gigi Notes, a delicious recipe that you can make over the weekend or during the week.
Yeah, and it'll be a great thing to take to school as a delicious snack. But what is that recipe? You will find out if you're subscribed to our Gigi Notes. That's all from Charlotte Bay. Till next time. That's all from us this week from Gigi Radio. We hope you have loved it as much as we have, and we hope to see you next week. Don't forget to read the chapter review. It is Psalms 91. And keep learning our verse of the week if you still haven't, which is verse 2 of Psalms 91.
And get ready for next week. We have some amazing devotionals. The first 3 days, we have a continuation story.
Ooh, I love those.
Yes. And we'll have a new artist, a new verse for you to learn, Bible trivia and archives. So get ready for next week. Have an awesome weekend. Blessings. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for another week. Thank you that we survived this week and you helped us through every challenge. Lord, I ask that you be with us this weekend. Give us the rest that we need to renew our soul. Also, Lord, help us always look up to heaven and be the great people that you want us to be and succeed in every area of our lives. Thank you, Lord, for everything. In your name I ask. Amen.
This has been Gigi Radio signing out.